3, 2, 1, go. You're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off.
This is the Self-Preservation Society. This is the Self-Preservation Society. Go wash your German badger boat race too. Come your bonnet fair, we got a lot to do. Put on your dinky dirt and your peck and rye, 'cause time to hurry and buy. Get your skates on, mate. Get your skates on, mate. No bib around your Gregory Peck today. Hey, drop your plates of meat right upon the sink. This is the Self-Preservation Society. This is the Self-Preservation Society.
We set out our mission statement to begin with, which was to raise money for children in a fun way. And we supported the first year Childline and Children in Need. And since then, we've always just stuck to that kind of ethos. It's just part and parcel of what the Italian Job is all about.
A seat in chaos, a smash and grab raid, and $4 million through a traffic jam.
The Italian Job started back in 1990. I'd come back from university in Italy, and some friends of mine had done the Beaujolais rally the year before, said it was wonderful, but it was a bit kind of testing in as much as it was a real hardcore slog, just 24 hours from the vineyards back to the UK. And with the contacts I'd made in the north of Italy, in the city of Trento, we managed to persuade some hoteliers and some winemakers in the area to welcome us, and we explained that we'd be descending, just a few of us, in minis, and we would be raising money for Children in Need and Childline. We then made the mistake of sending a press release to a magazine who ran with it and did it a big splash, and it was Autocar Motor. And then we found we were inundated with requests for people to come along and join us. So we took 55 cars that first year. And it was quite an interesting development, because that was alongside our jobs and our businesses and what we were doing. We were all young and fairly hard up at the time, so really the only cars that we were driving were minis. We had a massive passion for the Italian Job film, had done since the day it was we first saw it, and it was just such a great name to give to an event, the Italian Job. I mean, if we were going to France, we would definitely have called it the French Connection. So it would always been a theme on the film. And then there was a lot of synergies that came into play quite nicely there, where in the film they were called the Self-Preservation Society. They were going to Italy to do a job and they would benefit. What we were trying to do was go to Italy to do a job for children that needed the help from the charities that we were supporting. There's a really human element to what we do with the Italian Job, because, for us, the Mini has always been a classless car. You know, it transcended all those social stereotypes and social boundaries of wealth and those that have and those that don't. Anyone can have a Mini, and we get people from all walks of life. We have company directors through to young students who come along, people that love the car, and whether it be the old Mini, the classic Mini, or the new Mini, it doesn't really matter. There's a passion there for the car, and I've known people since I was a very young man in the classic Mini scene, and I can see that fervour and that enthusiasm and that passion repeated in new Minis. So clearly there's a similarity there. Simply because of some of the geography in Italy, really, you know, we always want to try and go to at least one of the points from the film, so Turin, for example, the Aosta Valley, up in the north of Italy. But then relatively close there, you've got all these wonderful little things and places that you can go and see. And around Modena in Emilia-Romagna, it's the heart of Italy's cuisine, but it's also the heart of Italy's engineering base, and that's when all the main cars, other than obviously the Fiat's in Turin and Alfa's, but Modena and the region of Emilia-Romagna is a very rich history of connection with automobiles and cars. So we need to keep going back there, because we recognise that our participants also want to be able to drive their Minis on some hallowed ground. So to say that they've driven on Imola and we get the circuit all to ourselves, and we're not there to race, we're there to kind of parade, and to be able to say, actually, this car, I've driven it around Imola. And people say, what, really? And you can show them when we stop at the scene of Senna's monument, or at Monza, to be able to go around escorted at a fair old lick as well. We don't kind of hang about, but it's not a race, and it's not about kind of beating the person in front of you.
I'm Susie Kinsman. I'm married to Alex, and we've been married for quite a few years now. And we got together because of minis. We met because of minis, and unfortunately, they seem to have run out of control. We do have one or two of them. I have a black GT. I've owned this car for over 20 years. He's done over 250,000 miles, and I've basically grown up with him. He wasn't my first mini, but he was my first bank loan. He's in really good condition, and so this year we decided to put a new engine in him and take him on the Italian job.
I'm Alex Kinsmore, I'm one half of Team 78. I've always wanted to do the Italian job, and any self-respecting mini nutter knows about it. Susie did it back in 92 or 93, something like that, which I'm very jealous of. And it was just like, it just came right this year, and we just got to do it, and it was fantastic. You're always attached to your first car, which I've still got. Nice beige 1968 Riley Elf, but that hasn't been on the road for about 10 years. I really got a soft spot for the white Elf as well, but that catastrophically failed an MOT 6 weeks after I bought it. I got an orange estate with a big engine in it that I've had a really good laugh with, that's quite well known, with a silly wing on it. And then I got the Union Jack car, which has been and done all sorts of interesting things with interesting people, not all of whom have had clothes on. I think it's genetic. I came home from the hospital in 1962 by the Elf. And from that point on, there's only been a period of about 4 years, maybe, when we didn't have one.
Okay, we have a very simple kind of colour coding system. We get a lot of people coming back on the Italian job year after year, or taking a break, etc. So every team, every jobber, for that is the name that we have given them, receives on their very first Italian job a green baseball cap, a forest green baseball cap with the Italian job logo. The organisers wear red so that we can be clearly seen wherever we go. And then once a jobber's done two events, on the third Italian job, they get a black hat. And then for every subsequent year afterwards, they get a number on the back of their baseball cap to show how many years they've done it. It's useful for us when we're doing a briefing for the navigational rally, because it means that we can say to any green hats who are either year one or two, if you need to speak to someone, because it is quite complicated, or the way I explain it can be quite complicated when it's not, they can then go and talk to someone with a black hat, especially a black hat with a number on it, and therefore know that they're getting a little bit more of experience from someone that's actually done the navigational rallying part as well.
To keep up with the others, too.
All right, all right.
Look out, they're behind us. You better put your foot down, put your foot down. We'll lose them easy.
We'll be right back.
very often that we get some good reactions in the towns and villages that we travel through, certainly in the Emilia Romagna and where we're basing the event, because we have to liaise with the local tourist office or the local mayor. There's a very formal sense of etiquette and political protocol you have to follow there. So if we want to park 60, 70 minis in a square, we need to get permission. And what they do then is they publicise or advise the local people that on this day there's going to be these English minis and minis from all over the world coming along and parking and just causing a bit of disruption. So we often get lots of locals coming along, and it's like anywhere you go in a mini, people will just love you, you know, look at you and smile and just kind of start talking about the car, where you've come from, how far, how comfortable, how uncomfortable it is. When we go past schools, again, school children come out, that's quite incredible. And we always have this tradition where we take, because we base the event in Italy, we always take presents and toys for a local children's charity that we know of in the areas that we are. And the reaction is just, it's like Christmas morning sometimes when you see this. And the ingenuity of the jobbers, the people that take part in the Italian job, and the gifts and the toys and the presents they bring, it's just amazing. So it's we get fantastic reactions.
It is so well organised. It really is a pleasure. All you need to do is to turn up and put fuel in your car and everything else is sorted out. They've got some superb route books which are very easy to follow. And in all else fails, you can always put your sat-nav on, cheating rather, but and the accommodation is all organised for you. It's absolutely superb. And they sort out the evening meals and the spread that you get. It's fantastic. You just turn up and they put all sorts of interesting things in front of you to try out and some lovely wines. It really does make it a holiday as well as a touring event.
And we go to Florence and get to manage to park all the minis in a square in the middle of Florence, a beautiful square. You'd have to murder a policeman to get that sort of parking location in normal times. And they've got a whole group of drummers and pipers and flag-waving people to welcome us. Then they lead us on a half-mile route march through the city amongst all the tourists to take us to a fantastic restaurant for lunch. Absolutely magical.
350. £325 we have from Alex Kingswood. £325.
Very good, Bob.
Excellent quality. £325.
We kind of try and add value in a very light-hearted way because we don't want to exploit people's generosity. And during the Italian job, every year we have an auction, and predominantly we kind of figure it's all going to be mini bits. It's going to be mini mats, mini car seats, mini exhaust, etc., etc. Every now and then something just really weird comes up and ends up getting sold for like £1,000. So there's one of our team, Pauline from Leighton Buzzard, does cross-stitch. When you put these things on a wall, they look like photographs, and she's offered now to do a cross-stitch as an auction item for anyone that bid, and it went to £1,000 for one guy who was going to pay £1,000 to have his car of his car made into a cross-stitch.
The tapestry was just, I wasn't going to be outbid on that, and eventually I went and had a word with Pauline and said, look, if we're getting silly, would you find match Bob's winning bid? Because, yeah, and then she did, so we're both getting one. So the charity gutted
Alex,
twice
started,
as well.
Alex, you started bidding against me.
No, you started bidding against me. It was a comedy moment. I put my hand up, Susie put her hand up, I put my hand up, Susie. Yeah.
We had a police escort through Turin, which was absolutely mad. The police guys on their motorcycles really got into the gist of it. They were going around the roundabouts and getting their legs down and their knees down as they were going. They were really joining in, and they were stopping all the traffic, and everybody was loving seeing the minis. People were peeping their horns at us, and we did have a breakdown on the way. The mini which had the green trailer, that was Terry and Dan in Roxy, and it basically exploded one of its water hoses near a bridge where the old weir is, I believe, which they used in the film. And it literally fell to pieces at the side of the road. And the service van, bless them, our saviours, they had to stop and literally tow it up onto the Lingotto roof. I don't know whether there's been many minis that have been towed up onto the roof, especially with themselves towing a trailer. It was rather unique.
There's always, on any event, I think any motoring event, there's always going to be the one golden dipstick car, the one that just, for whatever reason, just attracts the attention, needs attention of the service crew for everything. And there was this one car this year, and there was a gang of three boys in the car from Aberdeen. They'd come a hell of a long way to begin with. And it was a clean car, but it was just everything was going wrong. Fan, they had the fan on the wrong way, then they had a fin brake on the fan, and it was just a whole catalogue of disaster. Nothing major, nothing unstoppable, but you know, the number of times they arrived back under tow from the service van was quite incredible.
As far as the actual locations, I loved the Lingotto. The Lingotto is this wonderful old Fiat factory that they used in the old film, The Italian Job, back in the 60s. It's been converted to a hotel and shops and all sorts of restaurants and things. But with permission, you're allowed to drive up on the top. Now, naturally, the Italian Job themselves, they can pull a few strings, and that's exactly what we did with a police escort. And you drive out and round, it's almost like a multi-storey car park, going up through the layers where they used to produce the cars. And then you come out on the top with this marvellous paved area, and it's like about 45 degrees, and you drive out and you feel as though your car's literally going to drop down the slope. And you're looking out of your driver's window, and you're looking down on the roof of the Mini below you, and it was both wonderful and scary at the same time. A wonderful view of the city of Turin. That was my favourite bit.
It was, I don't know, like walking onto Wembley for a football person, or Twickenham for rugby, or Cheltenham for the Gold Cup for, you know, a horse racing. It was just unbelievable. Just three laps around there, getting ever so slightly quicker each time.
I had done another film called Robbery, which was directed by Peter Yates, starring Stanley Baker, about the Great Train Robbery, and I played the fireman on the train, and I had three words in that.
I can't argue.
I am going in the front. He says he wants to sit up in front with the driver.
I always get sick in the back.
Listen, if I go in the back, I'll get me migraine, I'll be out like a lump.
You are not going to be sick, you're not going to have your migraine, and everybody is going to sit in the back of the motor.
I think I was too young. My mum didn't let me go and see it. I look about 12 in that film.
I mean, I joke about the Italian Job, but I'm not the only person left alive. There are a few, not many. I think nearly all the principals, apart from Michael, have gone. So I think it's me and a few of the lads who are still going.
If I did the Italian Job again, it would be, firstly, I would love to meet up with our pals that we made along the way. You made some really good chums. You're all in it together, and it's really good fun. You get a real good sense of doing something when you're doing it for a charity event. We did it for the Variety Club this year. It's a very worthwhile charity, and it's really nice to feel that you're contributing towards that.
I was there when the boys said, I was standing next to him, I was slightly out of shot, I can't remember why, when he said, you're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off. I was actually there, so I'm one of the few.
I'm here to represent Variety Club, children's charity, and I'm thrilled to be on this event again. I did it five times when I was with the NSPCC, to come back here and see so many enthusiastic mini owners who have been really fabulous in raising so much money. Such a great range of people from all walks of life. It's one of the best things about this event. Can't speak highly enough about it. Thanks everyone for doing it so much. Hugely appreciated.
Hang on a minute, lads. I've got a great idea.
This is the Self-Preservation Society. The Self-Preservation Society. Put on your almond rocks and daisy roots. Flash your rhapsody, play your whistling flute. Lots of bloody doors and corpies here. Look alive and get out again.
The Self-Preservation Society. The Self-Preservation Society.